in the world of the professional video editing software, why you choose Avid instead of the other software?
Yeah, I'd like to hear this.
Well, well, I like the colors. Yeah. The incredible interface. Well, here's the weird thing. When I started, that was kind of the only game in town. It was the first one that spoke to filmmakers and was like designed for filmmaking. And it still remains a very filmmaker-friendly platform for motion pictures. And that's primarily what we do. But I will say that it's robust, it's really stable. Mm-hmm. It allows you to interact with your other departments like sound and visual effects in a way on a level that no other system does. There's nothing close in terms of that. Now you can design workflows with other software that does it, but it's like a rock when it comes to that. And the other thing that's happened is, and Paul Rubel said this once, he said Avid's not a computer program, it's like an extension of my nervous system. And I thought he was being a little nuts when he said that. And then, 10 years later, I'm like, oh, I get it. Because something you use every day starts to become part of your brain. It's the way you think, when you're building something. So in the same way that, word processing is, intuitive in a way, the interface for this for me is super intuitive. So I could switch and edit on another platform, but my process is like so intertwined with it. So I think it's the quality of the interface for me as a craftsperson, and it's the stability and the range of being able to share with other craftspeople like sound and music and visual effects.
And bin sharing doesn't hurt.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I mean, it's a collaborative software.
Right.
And so for us, that's like critical. And the resolution's great, the sound's great, all these things that you need, and they cannot be, it can't be like, oh, it works today, but it might not work tomorrow. No, it has to work every day, every single day. We didn't have a glitch, thank God, on, right. When you're trying to deliver these movies, you cannot have something go wrong. Because you're gonna push a button when the movie's done, after I QC the 2D DCP of that movie, we say, okay, that's it, it's done, this is on Endgame, boom, 6,000 copies of that movie go out across the world that fast. So, and you come up to it within an hour of that deadline to push that button. That software better get you there.